How is it going?
Badhiya ji, as they say in the Punjab. Excellent.
I don't know what it is in Punjab, but I know what is it in English. So next, we're jumping into the last module. And I'm completely privileged to introduce Harish. I got started in the internet after he got started 5-6 years in the internet. And he stuck with it, but I changed geographies, changed verticals. I'm completely blessed to introduce him. Harish has been one of my inspiring persons in my life as an entrepreneur, as a digital marketer. I wanted to invite Harish up and so that he can share how to go about building a digital marketing strategy specifically for social media. Okay? And while I'm completely overwhelmed in terms of introducing him, I'll read what we got here. No? An entrepreneur with CEO skill set. He has successfully created from grassroots level business in the area of consulting, e-commerce, as well as retail sales and distribution. 360 degrees understanding of all gamuts of business, including sales, marketing, branding, accounts, finance, HR, marketing. And that tells you how much of depth he had been there. Exposure to large companies, SME sector, as well as startups. So he has been, again, across the entire spectrum of the small, meet micro to the larger companies. Experience of dealing with businesses both in India as well as outside India, Southeast Asia, China, Middle East, America, and Europe. He's a passionate individual. That's what I completely get inspired with. You know, he has been creating businesses. He manages people, has a clarity of thinking in terms of what he wants to do. Probably that's where I stop and invite Harish to take part. Yes.
Welcome aboard. Thanks, Arun, for those very kind words. I'll be talking to you on how to go about creating a social media strategy for your brand. So when you build a social media strategy, what really is the challenge that brands are kind of up against? You know, once upon a time when there was no media, there was no print media, there was no television, there was no internet, the entire communication between a brand or a consumer was a one-to-one kind of communication. Okay, brands were disconnected, consumers were disconnected. And the only way you would market was the, you know, door-to-door kind of marketing. That's how business used to happen. Then at some point of time, media got created. So we had somebody will print a paper, we'll have somebody will create a television channel. And now a brand sitting at one place is all of a sudden able to talk to a whole lot of consumers. So the brand becomes the center of the universe, use the media, put a communication, and it reaches to all consumers. But consumers are still not connected. Okay, and this is the era that we call as the era of mass communication. And then something happened. Okay, internet came to town. Social networks came to town. Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Orkut, whatever you can hear came to town. And all of a sudden, consumers started getting connected. Now consumers can talk to other consumers. If as a brand, if as a business, all my customers can talk to each other, all my suppliers can talk to each other, all my clients can talk to each other, where is the room for brand messaging? As a consumer, if I want to buy a product, I will rather trust other consumers more than trust a brand. If I want to buy an iPhone and I put up a requirement on my Facebook page and I get 20 people giving me comments what kind of phone to buy, that will decide my purchase decision. It is not the large big ads I see on television, print, anymore which will decide my communication. So the challenge for brands is that when consumers are completely connected, how does a brand still weave its message, okay, across these media and find a way to engage consumers? That really is the challenge when we look at building a social media strategy. So the starting point of understanding social media, the operative word in social media is social. You know, people end up focusing more on the word media. The real operating word is social. The focus has to be on the word social. And social media marketing itself is an oxymoron. Social and marketing don't go hand in hand. What is marketing? Marketing is all about intimidation. Show the guy so much ad on television that he's completely blanked out. He starts believing that your product is the best product. You see that Vodafone ad 20 times in 1 hour, even in sleep you keep thinking of the Vodafone ad. It is hardcore intimidation. That is traditional marketing. It is carpet bombing. Okay? So you heard things like roadblocks. Have you heard that term roadblock in mass communication? Anybody knows what's a roadblock? So if you open a paper and you see only one brand all across, that is called a roadblock. No other brand in the paper. Only one communication happening. Okay? Or you switch on a TV channel At the same time, the same brand will communicate across all the channels. It's a roadblock. Okay, they want to block you completely. If I told you there's a roadblock happening somewhere in Andheri, what is the image that comes to your mind? What's the roadblock associated with?
Traffic,
Dadagiri, you know, that's the kind of focus, right? That's the term we use in computer. We call it roadblock. Dadagiri. We're not letting you say anything else. Okay. We use terms like carpet bombing in mass communication. Okay? Wherever you turn your head, there was an Aircel campaign running at one point of time. Anywhere you turn your head, the only word you see is Aircel. It is called carpet bombing. Okay, carpet bombing is a term used in war when you go and bomb the enemy. But as mass communicators, we use terms like roadblock, carpet bombing. So the art of mass communication is the art of intimidation. Intimidate the customer so much that he has no choice but to buy a product. Okay? If I go to a store and I look at cell phones and the shopkeeper shows me an iPhone, a BlackBerry, a Nokia, and maybe a brand like Carbon, which is not so well known. I like the features of Carbon, I like the price of Carbon. I will not have the guts to buy Carbon. Because if I take it home, my wife will shout at me. You can't even buy a phone. Because she's carpet bombed and intimidated into believing that these are the only brands you need to work. That has been the era of mass communication. But that era of mass communication or so-called interruptive marketing now comes to an end. When consumers can start talking to each other, and if all my friends tell me Carbon is the best brand to buy, I'm going to buy Carbon. So the power has suddenly shifted from the brand to the consumer. Brands need to understand this and their behavior needs to change. So what is the change in behavior? A brand needs to start becoming social. What is the meaning of the word social? Be helpful, be a guide, be a friend, be engaging. Okay, carry these adjectives back with you. When you start building a strategy, these adjectives will be very helpful to help you understand how as a business or how as a brand you need to manifest on social media. So the operative word of social media strategy is to become social. That's lesson number one. Lesson number two, okay? When you look at social media, it's not about creating a Facebook page or a Twitter page. There is no concept of a Facebook page. On Facebook, you're actually building communities. As a consumer, you never visit the page of the brand, okay, or you never visit the profile of a friend to pick up content. Content comes to you. Okay, so there is really no concept of a Facebook page or a Twitter page. You're actually trying to build a community. You're trying to get people together, okay, people who are your target audience, and find a way to engage with them. So your role is that of a community manager. When you think like a brand manager, the thoughts that come to your mind is how to push the brand. What to sell next, give them the next offer, give them the next discount, sales push karna hai. That's how a brand manager thinks. How does a community manager think? How to take care of the community? What can I give them to enrich their lives? How can I be more relevant to them? So the first transformation is, instead of being a brand manager, become a community manager. Think like a community manager. Communities are built around issues, they are not built around brands. Okay, none of us wants to join a Lux page or a Nivea page. Who's interested? I don't want to get brand offers. Communities are built on issues. So once you know your target group, identify some issue which is relevant to the target. Okay, issues are either aspirational in nature or pain point in nature. So if you identify a target group, identify what are their aspirations or what are their pain points, and try to build your community around those aspirations and pain points. When you build a community around that aspiration and pain point, the right kind of people come and join the community. And then you serve these guys well, and time to time you get an opportunity to put your brand communication out. So lesson number two is, think like a community manager, don't think like a brand manager. Third thing, put a community definition statement into place. Okay, when I try to build a community, see if you can create the statement for your business or for your brand. And the statement reads, I am going to build a community of, and then you put a target group, people who are going to target, and I will help the community by, how will I help the community? By reason of existence,